So title of our paper is Fight for Harmony, Secularism and its Problems in the Bababudangiri Hills. This paper is jointly written by myself and Professor J. Sadan. Bababudangiri is exalted as a place of religious harmony where Hinduism and Islam have coexisted for last several hundreds of years. There is a darga in the form of a cave situated at the top of the hill, which is also known as Guru Dattatreya Bababudan Swami Darga. This cave is held to be a place associated simultaneously with Dattatreya and Hazrat Dada Hayat Mir Kalandar. The former is a well-known Puranic personality, supposed to be a combined form of Trimurtis. This is termed as Hindu-Muslim syncretism. This syncretism presupposes a peaceful coexistence of two rival religions, a miracle that can only happen in India. This part of Indian culture, according to secularists, offers a solution to the Semitic world of religious rivalry. However, ironically enough, this very place is gripped by communal strife for last few decades. Those who are committed to secular principles think that this place is threatened by the communal forces, especially Hindu fundamentalism. The Hindutvavadins, on the other hand, hold the view that the stand taken by the secularists is not neutral. It is biased in favor of Muslims. For both of them, Bababudangiri exemplifies how Indian secular fabric is endangered by the religious fundamentalism. The problem viewed from this angle provides justification for the secular state to interfere in order to protect both Hindu and Muslim rights over this place. Now, if that the above description is sufficient to understand the problems in Bababudangiri, then we have certain questions to answer. They are, how the same religious groups which are pitted against one another now coexisted together peacefully to form a syncretism till 1975. Because since 1975, this dispute arises in that hill. Why the practices of two religions now appear to be threatening the very secular fabric with the entry of secular state, with its objective of protecting the syncretism of the place? Third question, how to account for the complaints of different religious and secular groups that the state is not taking neutral stand on this issue and therefore it is acting against the principles of secularism? The fourth question, how to account for the ambiguous and vacillating stand of the state in response to both the religious and secular demands? So, our contention in this paper is that what we want to argue in this paper is that the description Hindu-Muslim syncretism presupposes a conflict between two religions instead of peaceful coexistence. This shrine cannot be classified either as Muslim or Hindu, and therefore application of the concept of religious rights makes no sense here. But the secular state, true to its nature, took recourse to identifying it as a Hindu-Muslim syncretism. In other words, it presumed that the practices in that shrine were religious practices, and that shrine, both Muslims and Hindu devotees visited the place. It was construed as Hindu-Muslim syncretism. The description Hindu-Muslim syncretism for this shrine is an entry point to the realm of religious rights and secular program. Fight for the protection of religious rights in this shrine, once generated through the notion of Hindu-Muslim religions, sustains different types of claims and interpretations precisely because of this ambiguity. Therefore, this very description generates a series of disputes. And in the next section of our paper, we have narrated briefly the disputes going on in Bababudangiri Hill. There are roughly three stages, but what it demonstrates is that how identification of this shrine was actually a problematic in nature, and state did not know what is the nature of this shrine, and then they take certain decisions, and then it gets complicated, and then they switch over to some other decisions. So, here certain steps are shown. First, it was included in Mujhrai, Religious and Charitable Endowments Department in 1940s. And in 1975, when a work board was formed, this shrine was actually, it was listed under this work board jurisdiction. And actually, here we see that first they thought that it's a Hindu shrine, or it can be included in Hindu religious and charitable endowment department. Later on, it was shifted to the Muslim work board, where the Muslims managed that. And later on, it was actually contested. So the legal cases start from 1975. So when there was a dispute between these two parties, especially when it was included in the work board, the local Hindus and including the custodian of the shrine called Shakadri, they joined together and they appealed to the court, and both district and high courts, they actually passed an order to cancel the decision to include it in work board. Actually, it was not ultimately in effect. Work board to the decision to include this shrine in work board was a decision, but it was not affected. Before that, it was cancelled by the court. And later on, work board could not fight this case. And it's interesting to note that the district court, on what basis they decided that this cannot be included in work board. The district court says that since this place was worshipped by both the Hindus and Muslims, no religion could have exclusive rights over this shrine. Because this was the ground shown by the parties who contested the government decision to include it in Wakf Board. Because they told that this is not a simply Muslim shrine, there are Hindus and there are Hindu practices, so it violates the secular principle of the state. And this was upheld by High Court also in 1991. To put it in words of the judgment, the suit institution, the Guru Dattatreya Bababudan Swami, stands aloft as shining example of true secularism in this world, divided so sharply on narrow caste, communal and religious considerations. So thus ultimately the solution the state of, in the form of court, legal system, found us that it neither belongs to Muslims nor belongs to Hindus. Maybe both the religions have come together. So we have to recognize the Hindu-Muslim syncretism as the point there. So that Hindu-Muslim syncretism is protected to protect the secularism of our secular program. Thus, the idea of syncretism seems to solve the problem of deciding over the legal matters concerned with this shrine. But contrary to the fond hope expressed by the court, its decision on the issue turned Bababudangiri into a virtual battleground between the Hindutva Vadins and the secular forces. In this way, the idea of coexistence of two religions also seemed to create problems. Now, how the problem was created? Now, the Hindutva Vadins take up their religious rights. And strangely, actually, at that juncture in 1991, people thought that this problem is solved because it is Hindu-Muslim syncretism and that people have evolved for thousands of years. But no, these people started fighting for religious rights here. And Hindutva Vadins told that their argument is that this is not syncretism. So they argued that what we call syncretism is nothing but Islamization of this shrine, because this shrine originally belonged to Dattatreya. And in medieval period, the Muslim conquerors, especially during Hyder Ali's period, it was occupied. And then slowly they have stopped all the Hindu practices here. So now it has been turned into sort of Hindu-Muslim co-mixture. So now their target is to liberate this shrine from the clutches of the Muslims. And one of the programs is to introduce new rituals, because the court in 1991 in its order had ordered to maintain the pre-1975 status quo. So no more rituals should be introduced, because when the court ordered the district administrators to enlist the Hindu practices in this shrine, because they wanted to give a judgment to know whether it is really Hindu-Muslim syncretism. Then when they started enlisting it, then the Hindutva Vadins became aware of all these facts, and they found that the practices, Hindu practices, are not adequate here.